I'm Sankalpita and you're watching BookGeeks India, which is a channel where I make book-related videos. In this video, I bring to you some of the best and most anticipated books of 2018, the summer edition. So without further ado, let's just get into the video. Number 1. The Outsider by Stephen King. An 11-year-old boy's corpse is found inside the town park, and all clues lead to a famous person, a famous citizen called Terry Maitland. Now this guy, Terry Maitland, is a little league coach, he's an English teacher, a husband and a father of two girls. In the light of all these clues, Detective Ralph Anderson orders a very public and very quick arrest. But Terry Maitland has a very strong alibi. So then the investigations continue and some very horrifying secrets are discovered. So Terry Maitland seems like a nice guy, but is he wearing another face? When the answers come out, it'll shock you in a way only a Stephen King novel can. Book number 2, Leah on the Offbeat by Becky Albertalli. This book is a sequel to the very, very famous book Simon vs. the Homo Sapiens Agenda, which has now been made into a major motion picture called Love, Simon. In this book, the author tells us the story of Leah, who is Simon's BFF, as she struggles with changing friendships, first love, college life, and senior year troubles. Leah thinks herself as an exception, as an anomaly in her friend circle, and that's because she's not really as privileged as her other friends are, and also because though her mom knows it, she hasn't really come out with her bisexuality, even though her BFF Simon is openly a gay. As the equations change and the friendships change, Leah faces a new struggle. She's actually in love with somebody, but she can't really tell. Will she be able to help her friends who are busy fighting between themselves? So what will happen to Leah? This is her story and you need to read it. Book number 3 is Boss Down by Victoria Aveyard. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. This book is the conclusion to the New York Times best-selling Red Queen series. Mae Barrow, the little lightning girl, was almost broken by Carl's betrayal. She was heartbroken and she was destroyed. In this book, she will have to team up with the same guy who broke her heart in order to secure freedom for Reds and new bloods like her and overthrow the kingdom of Nota once and for all. With the help of Carl's powerful silver allies, the Scarlet Guard, Mae will find a formidable force which will beat the kingdom of Nota and throw away the crown on Maven's head. But will it be possible because Maven is a nuthead? He is driven by an obsession so deep that he will stop nowhere, he will stop at nothing to have Mae as his own again. Number 4. A Court of Frost and Starlight by Sarah J. Maas. This book is a companion tale to the number 1 New York Times best-selling A Court of Thorns and Roses series. The story of this book takes place 7 months after the explosive events that happened in the Court of Wings and Rune. Narrated by Fyra and Vesan, the story in this book bridges the gap between the events that happened in the Court of Wings and Rune and the upcoming novels in this series. Fyra, Vesan and their other companions are busy rebuilding the Night Court and the world that lays beyond. But Winter Solstice is finally here and it's time for some festivities. But as Fyra gets ready for her first Winter Solstice as High Lady, she understands and discovers that many of her companions have more wounds, deeper wounds than she anticipated. And these scars and these wounds will have a far-reaching impact on the future of their court. Number 5. From Twinkle with Love by Sandhya Menon. Aspiring filmmaker and world class, Twinkle Mehra has a lot to achieve. She has a lot of dreams and she wants to capture them all. So when fellow film geek Sahil Roy approaches her to direct a movie for the upcoming summer festival, she's extremely happy. Also, the thought of finally having a chance at romance with Sahil's attractive brother Neil drives her crazy. In the middle of all this, she starts getting emails from a mystery man called N, and Twinkle is very sure that this guy is Neil. Finally, she's getting what she wanted, but it's a slight problem. During the summer festival, she gets closer to Sahil and discovers in the end that love, after all, cannot be scripted and cannot be planned. Number 6. Adjustment Day by Chuck Palahniuk. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. Please forgive me if I'm not. The Adjustment Day is here and people are passing the word to only those people whom they trust the most. A mysterious book is being circulated amongst them and everybody who knows what's coming is reading it. Everybody is memorizing the directives mentioned in that book and preparing for the reckoning that will soon come. This book is a comic work which highlights the absurdities of our today's modern contemporary society. This is a society in which the politicians of the world plan to bring about a third world war in order to control the young male population of the world. Whereas the working class people plan to get rid of the elite class, the high class once and for all. Book number 7 is Florida by Lauren Groff. Lauren Groff is yet another New York Times bestselling author. In this book, she talks about a world where snakes, storms, and sinkholes are part of everyday life, but the greater dangers are posed by humans and their emotional and psychological nature. Amongst those people who navigate this world and those whose stories are told in this novel are a pair of abandoned sisters, a lonely boy, a childless couple, and an unforgettable and recurring character, a steely and strong-willed wife and mother. The stories in this collection spans characters, towns, decades, even centuries, but Florida, its landscape, its climate, and its history forms the central theme. Florida is as much an energy, a mood, as much it is a place of residence. Number 8. The President is Missing by Bill Clinton and James Patterson. Former American President Bill Clinton and best-selling thriller author James Patterson come together to bring us one of the most anticipated books of 2018, The President is Missing. During the period of an international crisis, a sitting United States president goes missing. What follows this incident are three most suspenseful and crucial days in the history of the United States. The book claims to be full of details which only a president can know, and in that sense, it is termed as one of the most authentic and compelling presidential thrillers. Book number 9 is The Mars Room by Rachel Kushner. The author of The Mars Room, Rachel Kushner, has been nominated twice for the National Book Award, which are United States Annual Book Awards. In this book, she tells us the story of a life gone off the rails in contemporary America. It is the year 2003 and a woman called Rumi Hall is at the beginning of serving two consecutive life sentences in a women's correctional facility in the Deep Valley of Central California. Her connections from the outside world, the San Francisco which she knew of her youth, and her son Jackson have been severed. Inside the facility, a new and challenging life awaits her. In a place where thousands of women struggle and hustle daily for bare necessities, security personnel, guards, and inmates carry out random and casual acts of violence, and people live a deadpan monotonous life, Rumi Hall will struggle to make every day happen, and this book is her story. Book number 10 is Warlight, a novel by Michael Ondaatje. Michael Ondaatje is a famous author who is known for his best-selling book, The English Patient. In the year 1945, just after the World War II, Nathaniel and his sister Rachel are left behind in London when their parents decide to move to Singapore, leaving them behind in London in the care of a mysterious figure called the Moth. They both suspect Moth to be a criminal guy and become increasingly sure of his identity when he, along with his weird group of friends, tries to protect and educate them in quite unconventional and unusual ways. All of the Moth's friends share a history of serving in the war, but nobody knows in what capacity, in what service, in what role. Their history, in fact, is a compelling mystery. Nathaniel and Rachel have no idea what is happening and what is being planned, and suddenly their mom comes back from Singapore without their dad and offers no explanation whatsoever. Almost a dozen years later, Nathaniel decides to uncover the mystery of his childhood, and this is what this book is all about. So guys, these are the most anticipated international book releases, international books of 2018. In case I have missed out on any book, please do let me know in the comments down below. I'll be happy to include it in a coming video. Also guys, do let me know about that one international book that you are most excited about this year. So comment down below about your most anticipated read. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. And that's it from me in this video guys. Thank you so much for watching my videos. Until the next video, which will be pretty soon. Bye.